45, we're down to our last five questions before we take the break. Which of the changes on the surface of the Earth is a chemical change? Now, we have two types of changes in chemistry. There's physical and chemical change. Let me see. Yes, I have a slide here. So these are physical changes. Well, these are chemical changes. Okay. Pag sinabi mong physical change, your composition of matter is still the same. Ganun pa rin yung composition of matter mo. Yung size lamang niya, yung shape lamang niya, yung naiba. Walang new form of matter na na-form. And it is very easy for you to put it back to its original form. Okay, so for example, melting, evaporation, condensation, boiling, deposition, sublimation, lahat ng change in the phase of matter mo, these are all just physical change. Tandaan po, melting, evaporation, boiling, deposition, sublimation, condensation, lahat po yan ay physical change lamang. Okay, that's just physical change. Chopping of wood is just physical change. Shredding paper is just physical change. Mixing gray and green marbles is just physical change. Bakit? Dahil pag chinap mo yung wood, eh wood pa rin siya. Pag shred mo yung paper, ginupit-gupit mo siya, eh paper pa rin naman siya. Pag nagmelt ang ice, tubig pa rin siya. Diba? Ice is just solid water. The same chemical composition. Wala pong naiba sa chemical composition niya, the same pa rin yung identity ng substance mo. So we call that physical change. Ang chemical change naman, there is a new product form. Hindi mo na siya mababalik sa kanyang original form. Very difficult na for you to put it back to its original form. So usually, so yung chemical change mo ay merong mga burning, may smoke, may odor, may flame. So for example, burning wood. Pag nag-burn na tong kahoy mo, hindi mo na siya mababalik sa kahoy na fresh. Rotting banana, pag nag-rot o nabulok yung saging mo, hindi mo na siya mababalik sa saging na fresh. Mixing vinegar and baking soda is an example of a chemical change. Fireworks are examples of chemical changes. Okay, so that's the difference between physical and chemical change. Physical change, ganun pa rin ang chemical composition ng iyong substance. Chemical change, nag-iba siya. There is a new product form. In physical change, very easy for you to put it back to its original form. Chemical change, mahihirapan ka na na ibalik siya sa original form niya. So baking is an example of chemical change. The composition is an example of chemical change. Alright, so 45. Which of the changes on the surface of the Earth is a chemical change? Is it letter A, the rising warm air from the ocean gets cold and forms clouds in the sky? The edges of the Earth's crust plates bend or rock when they bump each other? Salt crystals form when water containing dissolved sediments evaporates? Rocks under great pressure and temperature become harder? Okay, which one do you think is the correct answer for number 45? All right, let's take a look at the correct answer. Correct answer here is actually letter D. Letter D is the correct answer. Bakit D? Now, as I have mentioned a while ago, when matter changes its phase, for example, the processes evaporation, condensation, boiling, all these things are just physical change. So dito, sinabi warm air from the ocean gets cold and forms clouds. Clouds po are just formed through evaporation. Okay, so evaporation lang to. So that means that cannot be a chemical change. The edges of the Earth's crust plates bend or rock when they bump each other. Pag nag-bend yung edge ng crust ng Earth mo, when they rock, when they bump each other, crust pa rin naman sila. There's no change in the chemical composition. So that cannot be your chemical change. Letter C naman, salt crystals form when water containing dissolved sediments evaporates. This is still evaporation. As I have mentioned, evaporation, boiling, melting, freezing, sublimation, deposition, all those processes that are involved in the changing of the state of matter, pag nag-change ka ng matter to solid, to liquid, to gas, those are all just physical change. But letter D here, rocks under great pressure and temperature become harder. Yes, this is correct dahil maiiba na ang type of rock mo. Remember, we have three types of rocks, sedimentary rocks, igneous rocks, and metamorphic rocks. So when your rocks are put under great pressure and temperature, they are actually going to become igneous rocks. Okay, magiging igneous rocks po sila, magiging metamorphic rocks. So maiiba na yung composition ng rocks mo, maiiba na yung appearance din ng rocks mo. Okay, so letter D is the correct answer for number 45.